بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيب قلوبنا أبي القاسم المصطفى محمد وعلى أهل بيته الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين المنتجبين وعلى أصحابه الغر الميامين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان فمن شهد منكم الشهر فليصم ومن كان مريضا أو على سفر فعدة من أيام أخر يريد الله بكم اليسر ولا يريد بكم العسر ولتكملوا العدة ولتكبروا الله على ما هداكم ولعلكم تشكرون صدق الله العلي العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الكريم ونحن على ذلك من الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين The best period that we experience in our entire year is this season, the season of the month of Ramadan. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Ramadan Sayyid al-Shuhur." This month is the leader, is the master, is the jewel of the entire year, all months. The month of Ramadan. And he states, إِنَّهُ قَدْ أَقْبَلَ إِلَيْكُمْ شَهْرُ اللَّهِ بِالْخَيْرِ وَالْبَرَكَةِ وَالْمَغْفِرِ This month is a bringing with it. If we pay attention, we feel that. If we pay attention, we can feel the blessing of this month. One of the blessings is what you see now. People are gathered tonight. Otherwise, they would have been sitting at home and watching TV. But they have gathered tonight to recite dua, to listen to the Quran, to reflect, to solidify their social ties, to greet each other, to welcome each other, to embrace each other. Bil barakati wal rahma and mercy wal maghfira. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates these seasons for us. For us. So He finds an excuse to forgive us. Allah wants to forgive us, but He wants to find an excuse for us. So He creates the month of Ramadan. And He says that if you fast, paying attention to your fast, paying attention, realizing the value of your fast, and forbidding. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day said to Jabir. Jabir was one of the close friends of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said to him, "Ya Jabir," his name is Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari, a noble man. He said to him, "Ya Jabir, man sama fi hadha ash-shahr, sama naharahu wa qama wirdan min layli." You fasted during the days, and then you stand wirdan, a small part. Wird means a small part, not the whole night. 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. This is wirdan min layla, a portion, small portion of the night. And then he or she safeguards his eyes from looking into something forbidden, and his ears from listening or hearing something forbidden, and his mouth from saying something bad or forbidden. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end of the month, he will He will make him as if he's a newly born person. A newly born person with a brand new record, brand new file. There is nothing bad in your file. The other day I was driving, and on one of these traffic lights, I saw a sign, beautiful sign, just 2 days ago. The sign says, fix your credit. Fix your credit. And they put a number. We should do this with God. Fix your credit with God. You have to fix your credit. Here, you have to fix your credit in this life, definitely. In order for you to lead an honorable life, you need to fix your credit. But suppose you could not. So what? Millions of people who have bad credits. They survived. But if you don't fix your credit with Allah, you are in big problem. Big trouble. You can't afford having a broken credit with Allah. And this is the time. This is the time, the month of Ramadan, of fixing our credits, our accounts with Allah. Now on that sign, there is a telephone number, 949, whatever. Allah says, you don't need a telephone number. You come to me anytime, anytime. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. No one in this universe is so reachable, so open, so easy to reach and to speak to than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If you want to get an appointment sometimes with your brothers, you can't find him. Your brothers. You have to wait 2 days, 3 days until you can find your brother and talk to him on the phone. Allah does, you don't need to wait. You don't need to wait 2 days or 1 day or 1 hour. وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي, once they ask me, I am there, I am available 24/7. فَلْيَسْتَجِيبُوا لِي وَلْيُؤْمِنُوا بِي. So this is the month of Ramadan. Brings an abundance of goodness and barakah and forgiveness and opportunity. And when we fast, we accomplish many goals. Some of these goals are physical. Material and physical. Fasting is good for your body. If they ask you at the school, if they ask you in your neighborhood, your friend, why do you fast? Tell them because Allah prescribed fasting because it has many benefits. Number one begins with your own physical structure. There is a book, I was reading a book the other day. The title of the book is Healing Through Fasting. Healing Through Fasting. You don't need to go to a doctor and use medicine and this and that. Allah says fasting is a good way of healing, healing your body. First of all, it gives your body a time to rest, to relax. This body is working throughout the year, throughout the months, the days. We don't give a rest for the stomach. So this is an opportunity for the body to become revitalized, to relax, to rest. Again, they tell us that it is also an opportunity, fasting and siyam is an opportunity to dispense and dispose all the intoxicants in your body. You get rid of them. It helps the digestive system to work better for those who fast. And it has many, it stimulates your cells. It has many medical benefits for the body. This is number one. Then you come to the psychological effect of fasting. It has a good psychological effect. It gives your mind the ability to control. Most of our disasters that we see, that we create through our own selves, because we lack self-control and self-restraint. We are too weak to say to your mind, no, don't do that, too weak. We know this is wrong. We know many things are wrong, but still, despite knowing they are wrong, we do them. Fasting comes and teaches you to say no. To say no to the bad things and to say yes to the good things. And also, spiritually, it's important. Spiritually, when you have the food, but through your own will. Your own will. Even I look at some kids. Fasting is not mandatory on them still. It's not wajib on them to fast. But they can say no, although they need the food, they know that they need the drink, but they say no. This will build their character. It will build their character. The more we are able to detach ourselves from maddiyat, materialism, the more we can resist maddiyat, the bigger and the greater we grow, and the closer we get to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The closer we get to Allah. To be able to say to your temptations and to your desires, no, I'm not going to give in to your desire. My soul, I'm not going to give in to everything you ask me for. I'm not going to listen to you. I'm strong. And some of these desires, some people have desire for money, for wealth. They know nothing in this universe except wealth or money. All their relationships, even their relationships with their family members, with their parents, with their children, is based on money. That's very bad. Some people have desire for other things. Islam says you have to control yourself. If you want to build yourself, if you want to be an honorable person, if you want to differentiate yourself from animals, you have to build yourself. The tragedy that happened last night in Charleston. Why did this tragedy happen? Today the president, in his speech in the morning, he said these things does not happen in other countries. Why it happens in America? What's wrong with America? Shouldn't America be the model of humanity and compassion and cooperation? Why this race issue is still lingering? They could not find a solution to it. Someone who gets a gun from his father two years ago. His father gives him a gun as a gift, as a present for his birthday. Imagine. You give your son who's 20 years old, 19 years old, a gun for his birthday? Give him something useful. Give him something to build his brain, his character, his soul, his future. You give him a gun, real gun, and he's 19 years old, and you know your son is not stable. What's wrong with people? This is because people are away from Allah. This is because people are attached to this dunya. They become completely blind. Completely blind. We need to go back to Allah during this month. We need to go back. We need to resurrect, renew our faith, our humanity. We have to renew it. This guy comes and he sits in the class for 1 hour, Bible study class, for 1 hour. And he listens to the class and he listens to the Bible, and then he decides to stand. And then he shoots 9 people, 3 men, 6 women, who came to the Bible study class. They came to focus on their religion, on their unity, on their community. And then he runs away. And this problem is common today, because people are focused on dunya. And when someone is focused on dunya, he becomes like animals. Even animals, they have limits. Believe me. When it comes to animals, they do have limits. In their aggression, they do have limits. But when man becomes detached from Allah, from the truth, from reality, he becomes worse than animals. أُولَٰئِكَ كَالْأَنْعَامِ بَلْهُمْ أَضَلْ بَلْهُمْ أَضَلْ. This is an example of it. The guy who killed 9 last night. And one of the benefits of Siyam and the month of Ramadan is social. Social. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to bear the hunger. I was reading a survey last night We are very lucky here in Southern California. How many hours we fast? 16? About 16. You know, in Iceland, Reykjavik, the capital of Iceland, they fast 23 hours. They have 1 hour to break their fast, to do salat and iftar, and then suhoor immediately, and then back to business. 23 hours. In Stockholm, I was speaking to one of my friends in this morning in Denmark. He said in Stockholm, they fast for 20 hours. There's a huge Muslim community in Stockholm in Sweden. 20 hours. This is very long. Then why? We ask, why should I bear hunger? Allah says there is a reason for that. Listen to Imam al-Sadiq. Listen to what Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salatu wasalam says. And Hisham ibn al-Hakam, one of his disciples, سألت أبا عبد الله الصادق عليه الصلاة والسلام عن علة الصيام. The reason. علة means reason. Why do we fast? عن علة الصيام. فقال عليه الصلاة والسلام العلة في الصيام. The reason. ليستوي به الفقير والغني. The fakir, the poor, the hungry, who goes hungry every single night, every single day. He goes hungry. Every single, even here in America. Even here in America, there are individuals and families that go hungry every single day. Allah says the rich, He says the rich and the poor. I want the rich to understand the pain of the poor. If they don't become hungry, they would not understand it. If they don't feel that situation themselves, they're not going to appreciate it or understand it. ليستوي به الفقير والغني وذلك لأن الغني because the rich لم يكن ليجد مس الجوع فيرحم الفقير because if Allah does not ask us to fast we would never understand or realize how hunger or starvation hurts we don't understand the pain today most of you realize the pain because this is day number one for you And day number one is more difficult than other days. And most of you today were not feeling well. Most of you. Allah wants you to go through this. So you pay attention to others who are starving. One third of the humanity today, my friends, one third, meaning 34% of the humanity, they live below the poverty level. One third. Don't look at us. Living in an affluent society, affluent country. I've been to Africa just recently. Last month I was in Africa. And I saw people who live in deplorable conditions. Very deplorable conditions. Terrible conditions. A father cannot even afford a loaf of bread, let alone meat or fruits or vegetables. Forget about that. A loaf of bread for them is a dream. We have to think about that. This is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, in the Holy Quran, that some of the guilties on the Day of Judgment, they say, لَوْلَا أَخَّرْتَنِي إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ قَرِيبٍ Oh Lord, you should have given me few more days. Why? Allah says to him, why do you need few more days? You know the answer? He says, لِأَصَّدَّقْ So I pay charity, sadaqah. He does not say to pray or to fast or go to Hajj or do this. He says, no, no, no. لِأَصَّدَّقَ وَأَكُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ So I can pay sadaqah. He wants to come back to this life just to pay charity and sadaqah to save himself from punishment. This is why Islam says sadaqah is above all. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ Allah says, those who reject religion, the first thing they do, He did not say they did not pray or they did not fast. أَرَأَيْتَ الَّذِي يُكَذِّبُ بِالدِّينِ فَذَٰلِكَ الَّذِي He repulses the orphan. He does not give. He does not give. يَدُعُّ الْيَتِيمِ وَلَا يَحُضُّ عَلَىٰ طَعَامِ الْمِسْكِينِ He does not feed the destitute. This should be number one. This is why Allah wants me and you to fast. to realize the pain that they go through. So we can give, we can share. This is why one of the best a'mal, my friends, in the month of Ramadan is to share your iftar with others. Share the iftar. The Prophet ﷺ said, O Muslims, tasaddaqu, give your iftar. Share your iftar. They said, Ya Rasulullah, ma kulluna yaqdiru ala dhalik. We can't afford. We don't have enough money. We don't have enough food. He said, ittaqu an-nar walau bishiqqi tamrah. Protect yourself against hellfire, against punishment, with not only one full piece of date, half piece of date. Half. Bishiqqi tamrah. Ittaqu an-nar, protect yourself against punishment. Against punishment, walau bisharbati ma, with one sip of water. Give it to someone at the time of iftar. Go on, give it. Get the thawab. Allah wants you to share. Ma amana bi. Listen what the Prophet says, and I conclude here. Powerful statement by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Ma amana bi man bata shab'anan wa jaruhu jara. Our duty here, all of us, women, men, young. The young, you have to learn this from this age, tender age. You have to learn to share your food with others. One of the common mistakes that we do with our children is that when they come back from school, we tell them, Daddy, how is your grade at the school? If the grade is A+, we are happy. If the grade is B, C, D, whatever, F, we get frustrated. So the kids, they think that his father or his mother, all their attention and all their concern and all their desire is to see their children excel academically, period. While if you ask your son when he comes back from school, Daddy, did you share your meal today with someone who did not have food? Did you share your sandwich? Did you share your drink? Did you help someone that you saw he was in distress, maybe crying, sitting in that corner? Did you go to him or her and ask him, what's wrong? Can I help you? Did you say thank you to your teacher after a long day? These things we have to teach our children. Life is not about only good grades. Some people, they have good grades at school, but they are the worst in their families, in their communities. Allah says, ilm and iman, ilm and akhlaq. If you take akhlaq and manners, if you take it outside, if you take it out of ilm, ilm is nothing. Ilm is nothing. The Holy Quran tells us that some of the big ulama and scholars, they were the most corrupt because they did not implement what they learned. لِمَ تَقُولُونَ مَا لَا تَفْعَلُ. We have to teach our children moral values. When they go to school, they have to help. They have to put others before themselves. Something is missing in our community. Something is called sacrifice. It's missing. We have to teach our children how to sacrifice, how to work for others. Once they work for others, Allah will work for them, believe me. I know of a person who went somewhere, he had no house, but he was working for others. He himself had no house, no place to stay. He would stay 1 month here, 1 month there, 2 weeks here, like a homeless person. But he generates money to give to others. He has money, but he does not use it for himself. Allah brought him somewhere from nowhere. He purchased the land and he built a house for him and he said to him, come and sit in this house. When you work for others, Allah works for you. كَانَ اللَّهُ فِي عَوْنِ الْعَبْدِ مَا كَانَ فِي عَوْنِ أَخِيهِ. As long as you are of help to your brothers and sisters in the society, Allah will be of your help. He will be on your side. You don't have to worry. I always say to some parents, To some mothers and fathers, I tell them, as long as you help people, don't worry about the future of your children. Don't. Even if you leave no money for your children, no inheritance, no money, they will be okay. There is someone there taking care of them. So we have to teach these values. This is the month. The month of Ramadan is the opportunity for us to go back to Allah, to reflect. My advice for you, my friends, my brothers, my sisters, to cut back on futile activities. Cut back on things that has no benefit for you. Try to focus on the Quran during this month, on the dua. I'm going to speak, inshallah, tomorrow, Salatul Jum'ah. Try to go to the masjid, wherever there is masjid, mosque near you, try to be the first one to go there during the month of Ramadan. Try to read the Holy Quran, لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ رَبِيعٍ وَرَبِيعُ الْقُرْآنِ شَهْرُ رَمَضَانِ. For everything, it has a spring where it glows and flourishes and blossoms. And the spring of the Quran is when? The month of Ramadan. It means that we have to read it. We have to read this book. Try to read at least one juzu. One juzu. The Quran has 30 juz. One juz. If you can't read it properly, use audio things. Listen to other reciters and follow them and read the Quran. And reflect on what Allah is telling you. This Quran can be your shafi' on the day of judgment. The book comes and says, Ilahi, my Lord, Fulan, took care of me, respected me, implemented me. He will stand with you, the Holy Quran. Allahumma khfir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat, wal muslimina wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Tabi' Allahumma baynana wa baynahum bil khayrat. Also remember to pray during this month, especially at the moment of iftar, for the distressed people, the people of Yemen, who are still during the month of Ramadan, they experience bombing and fire and destruction. For the people of Syria, for other mu'mineen, wherever they are, wherever there is mazloom, someone who is being abused. For the African American people, today they broke my heart. They broke my heart. 200 years into this democracy, still the African American, they have no rights and no respect. Still the issue of race dominates this country. How can we provide others with respect and human rights and democracy and equality while your own citizens where the president is black, but the black people are disrespected, they have no rights? This is a problem. This is a problem. They have to work on it. Serious problem. We pray for them, inshallah, for their victory. For this racism and prejudice and hate, the culture of hate, to end, inshallah. To bring about, inshallah, real peace and real happiness and real justice. But remember, the champion of justice and peace is our Imam, Al-Imam Al-Mahdi Al-Muntadhar, Hajjalallahu Ta'ala Farajahu Al-Sharif. So let's pray for him. A'udhu billahi min ash-shaytan ar-rajim. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma kun li waliyika al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan. صلواتك عليه وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا واجعلنا اللهم من أنصاره وأعوانه وتقبل صلاتنا وصيامنا ودعاءنا في هذا الشهر العظيم وشافي مرضانا وداوي جرحانا وفك أسرانا وسجناءنا واغفر ذنوبنا وعجل في فرج مولانا وسيدنا صاحب العصر والزمان وإلى أرواح المؤمنين والمؤمنات والشهداء ثواب الفاتحة مع الصلاة على محمد وآل محمد.